Well, Back in Black was the first moment where Brian Johnson made his appearance with the band since Bon's passing, and I think AC/DC fans around the world, including myself, were waiting and waiting to see what would come through. And I knew something of Brian from the very early days when he was in the band in Newcastle in the north of England, and I thought it was just a great choice to get him to pick up the mic where Bon left off. I think there was a sense of relief when that song kicked off, and everybody felt, oh, this is great, you know, it's real sad that Bon's gone, but here's Brian, he's doing an incredible job, AC/DC is still together out there in the world of rock and metal, and going to be strong and great, and that was just a wonderful album to experience.
I interviewed Brian Johnson once, and he told me that after he sang his vocals to Back in Black, he actually walked out of the studio, and it was recorded in the Bahamas, and he went on his own to the board, to the beach, and he sat there with a beer and a cigarette trying to ponder what he was going to do next in his career, because he thought that the vocals were so high and the way he sang them on the record was just so high, the way he sang, that there was no way it would ever get played on the radio. And he was convinced that AC/DC, the rest of the band, would listen to the record and say, we got to find another singer because this guy just can't get it done. It's just too high for us to be able to sell a record like this. And obviously, Brian did okay. You know, he hung in there.